Hello everyone! Today I wanted to share with you something I have been using to help me better outfit my prayer life, and that is my very own DIY altar or a prayer table. As I like to express, your room is a little bit like a physical manifestation of your mindset, right? I spend a lot of time in my room, just like I do inside my own head, sometimes way too much time there. So I found that the more scripture and prayer I incorporate into my space, the better my daily walk is doused with an even closer fellowship with Christ. Now, I'm not saying that I'm an expert in prayer or faith or Christianity or whatever, but this is something that very personally helps me to spend time in focused, intentional, and scripture-based prayer. So, all you're gonna need is a cleared-off surface and a quiet place. That is very important that it's quiet, preferably at a height that you'd be able to reach sitting on your knees if you plan to kneel. You can decorate it, make it your own. If you can't tell, I'm a total plant lover. Also, yes, in case you were wondering, that is an incense burner. I don't use that for religious or meditation purposes. I literally just think that it smells good, and that's it. At the heart of my table, we've got the Bible, two, actually, in my case, just to have different versions. And the point of this is to be able to use verses from God's word while praying in order to strengthen your confidence in prayer. It's going to help keep your focus on God's purpose rather than our own. And even for me, it actually brings so much more joy and peace in my heart when I am using God's word when I'm praying instead of just rambling off to God what's in my head. Besides the Bible, I have two little booklets. One is a prayer journal if you use anything like that. And also the other is a list of key verses I can refer to when I want to look up something to pray for specifically. Behind it all, taped to my windowsill, is a string to hang some of my favorite Bible verses to always keep in mind, and also an envelope full of information, pictures, reports dedicated to our sponsored child that we support through World Vision. Obviously, I'm not going to show her face for privacy reasons, but her name is Fazia. She tells me that she loves to jump rope, and the little pin on the globe marks exactly where she's from in Ethiopia, which is a place called, I think, Jawtumanga. Having her posted here reminds me to keep her and her family and her community at the forefront of my prayers. Last thing is a tip I want to share. Get a pillow to sit down if you're going to be kneeling. My old lady knees and this hardwood floor is not a friendly combination. Get a pillow and make yourself comfortable while you're here, and I just store my pillow in my chair or beside the table or wherever whenever I'm not using it. And that's pretty much it. If you're like me, you probably fall asleep when praying at night, or you get super distracted praying during the day, so this forces your brain to say, okay, I'm coming before God with the sole purpose of talking to Him without dividing my time up to multitasking or other things. Now you've got your very own makeshift altar that you don't have to wait until church to use. You can start your day here, end your night, come whenever something's on your heart. However you want to use it, I hope it'll prove to be a blessing in your prayer life. I want to challenge y'all to take prayer seriously this year. If God says that we should pray without ceasing, why not create a space just for that? Thanks for watching, guys. Love the world. Stay empowered, you son of a gun. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.